Nadszedł czas zmiany, przejścia do prawdziwego działania wszechświata. I nadszedł czas, aby zrozumieć, że używamy stanu materii, by osiągnąć poziom zrozumienia duszy człowieka. Teraz rozumiesz, być może, dlaczego Kreator wysłał swoich posłańców w imię tego, co miałeś. To oni przynoszą uszy, aby można było ich użyć, gdy nadejdzie czas Mesjasza. Mogę nauczyć duszę i przesłanie. Nie by się przeciwstawiać, ale poprzez ich zrozumienie, przez tych, którzy stali się Mesjaszami, aby dawać ze swoich dusz, aby ich elewować. Zadanie stało się łatwe. Szkoła jest tutaj i uczniowie są tutaj w oddaniu. Wtedy nie będzie żadnej walki między tym, co nazywają muzułmanami a chrześcijanami. Baranek i lew będą jeść i spać w tym samym gnieździe. Chrześcijanie i muzułmanie będą spać i modlić się w meczecie, w tym samym kościele, w imię ich dusz, nie w imię religii, które są używane do tworzenia tak wielu konfliktów. Dla korzyści tych, którzy byli hiperaktywnymi dziećmi. Nadszedł czas, czas zmian jest tutaj. I jak powiedziałem, moje życzenie jest moim rozkazem. Jeśli pragniesz ujrzeć pokój, droga pokoju jest wyłożona bardzo wyraźnie. To dusza świadomości zbiorowej. Poprzez dawanie stworzy tą pozycję zmiany. Nic innego. W duszy człowieka nie ma długopisu. Jestem pewien, że po wejściu do społeczności uniwersalnej nigdy nie zobaczysz niczego zapisanego, ale równowagę pól duszy egzystencji. Staraj się być na tyle pokornym, aby nie stać się aroganckim w mocy, którą zrozumiałeś i posiadłeś. Inaczej wpadniesz w tą samą ścieżkę kościoła i meczetu. To jest to, co obiecaliśmy i to właśnie dostarczyliśmy. Musimy zrozumieć działanie duszy i musimy zrozumieć, że dusza człowieka jest gwiazdą w kosmosie wszechświata. Jeśli porównamy duszę człowieka i tak wielu nas, 7 miliardów w jednym zbiorze, Ziemia jest jak galaktyka z tak wieloma gwiazdami. Kiedy patrzymy w głąb Wszechświata, widzimy galaktyki z setkami milionów gwiazd. Podobnie jest z planetą Ziemią. Niesie 7 miliardów pięknych gwiazd, które są duszą człowieka. Niesie z sobą duszę tak wielu trylionów zwierząt, roślin i wszystkiego innego. Jeśli więc patrzą ci, którzy nie widzą fizyczności Ziemi, i jej zawartości, co widzą? Widzą galaktykę z wielką ilością pięknych, świecących świateł. Każda według swojej siły. Każda zgodnie ze swoją pozycją. Niemowlę ma piękną duszę, podobnie jak staruszek. Dla tych niefizycznych, którzy nie widzą fizycznego wymiaru tej planety, ale widzą siłę pola, jesteśmy gromadami gwiazd. Ludzka rasa, każda pojedyncza dusza, nikt z daleka nie widzi. To jest dusza rybaka, to jest dusza kosmologa, to jest dusza prezydenta. Wszystkie świecą bez względu na fizyczność. To jest magia. Oto co nowa nauka musi przynieść człowiekowi. Kiedy patrzymy przez naszą duszę, widzimy tylko gwiazdy w innych duszach. I to jest przełom, to jest zrozumienie. Na tym właśnie polegają te wszystkie nauki. Dojście do dojrzałości następnego poziomu, aby zrozumieć daleki kosmos. Wszechświat jest ostrygą dla tych dusz, które służą. Wtedy człowiek jest gotowy do wejścia w kosmos. Wtedy człowiek jest gotowy, aby stać się częścią uniwersalnej społeczności, która została obiecana. Nigdy nie obiecywałem wam nieba. Zawsze obiecywałem wam elewację człowieka, aby przyłączył się do rodziny. A teraz macie klucz. To wy musicie otworzyć drzwi, aby zrozumieć, że mogę elewować duszę tych ludzi lub milionów innych dusz, że fizyczne życie na tej planecie zmieni się. Wtedy jestem godny bycia częścią społeczności uniwersalnej, by być, aby służyć, aby się rozwijać, by być tam, aby być częścią, że w cyklu życia wszechświata staje się w byciu częścią, staje się częścią totalności. Kiedy człowiek osiągnie ten punkt, pojawi się nowy wymiar w sile duszy człowieka, który jest poza wyobrażeniem zrozumienia życia fizycznego. To jest brama do otwarcia nowego życia w nowym wymiarze, co jest poza wyobrażeniem tego, co mogliście nazwać nowym początkiem, nowym cyklem, gdzie ten cykl niesie ze sobą źródło stworzenia życia we wszechświecie i unikosie. To jest elewacja duszy, aby służyć. Stała się kluczem. Nie tron życia fizycznego. Czas jest odpowiedni, nadszedł czas, aby człowiek przeszedł przez ten proces.
Witamy wszystkich na 321 warsztatach poszukiwaczy wiedzy w języku polskim. Dzisiaj mamy niedzielę, 22 grudnia 2019 roku i tematem jest kontynuacja tłumaczenia 306 warsztatu poszukiwaczy wiedzy w języku z języka angielskiego na język polski. I tu mamy czas od 2 godzin 18 minut, z tym, że skończyliśmy ostatnio na godzinie 46 minutach i od tamtego czasu mamy przerwę w tłumaczeniu, tak więc zaczynamy od 2 godzin 18 minut do 3 godzin 28 minut. Tak więc w tej przerwie, z tego co wiem, były informacje na temat warsztatów prywatnych, z tego co tak w pierwszym, tak gdzieś dosłyszałem, nie wiem, Przemek może będzie później, tak więc coś dopowie na ten temat. Tak więc zapraszam do obejrzenia i wysłuchania.
There is one a question about Dan had about is what about the plasma times? We haven't had a new issue in a while. Is that going to be
plasma plasma time, the past three issues, it's all been done. I was talking to Anna a couple of days ago about it. We've been so busy with so many other things that it all needs to be done, and we are putting it, I think the way I understand as she's handling it, it'll be all the articles are there, it's outsourcing to put it together, and they'll come out in the all of them in the next few weeks, all be updated. It's the foundation, since I've come back from China, is expanding very, very slow, but very solid. That we can handle everything, and this part is now, I know, it'll be done in the next few weeks, complete, we'll be up to date, hopefully, by sometime in January, with all the issues. It's all documents, most of them are there, it's just putting it the right way.
Good, thank you. We had a question from Andrew in the YouTube. Can you ask if the Labor or Conservatives would be more Keshe Foundation friendly in England's general election today? That's a loaded question in a way.
That's a very loaded question. Let me explain to you what happened. In 2015, the British Health Ministry called for a meeting of the health ministries of EU in respect to the Keshe Foundation. We are aware of it because I was informed of it. And they made a tentative decision that is a cottage industry, and when it grows up enough, then the governments will look at it. And this was initiated by the British government. The application of the new technology will come through the health of it. That's for sure. Especially with the new system, the new what we call enhancement systems, is such a big elephant that nobody can ignore it. You've got to understand what it means. But we are coming in the path of the space technology. This is to develop for a space. And this will go the same way. We need to extend it. Keshe Foundation work is known by all the European nations and most of the world governments. And it has reached the point of its international recognition. You will understand very soon what I mean. We set up the conference in Vienna, then in Brazil, and we're going to Malta, and we saw a lady from Italy who came to Austria. She wanted to show her magic work, we didn't allow her, so she went back and wrote a lot of rubbish out of her despise that she couldn't show her magic, it had nothing to do with the plasma. And we let this kind of what we call stupid behavior. But in general, our work to these conferences are becoming very positive. Governments are getting involved, and the first MOUs have been signed. The first MOUs with the local business people has been signed. Now we're moving into the understanding local with the governments. And we see the benefit of what we started with Vienna. Vienna has been, if I understand what is going on, very few members of the diplomatic corps who attended. they brought a lot in the background in one or two cases which we are working on. The Brazil has reached our target. We have no problem in Brazil. Our next meeting in Malta in January will bring another facet. We are targeting diplomatic connection that they hear, but we're targeting governments. And governments see it. You will hear about the success of the Keshe Foundation in the last two conferences and the one to come very, very soon. We expect a very positive results from Mexico. In Kenya, we're going there to complete. We have reached agreements with the officials of Liberian government to most probably set up the first factories in Liberia for helping the country. We had meeting with the ministerial level and we achieved our agreements in that position. We understand the gravity of how it's coming. We're looking for a conference in Philippines. In the Far East, we have a very strong Philippine groups to talk to the Keshe Foundation to set up a conference that we can be there to bring it. Because I know when sometimes in February or whatever, there's always usually a university conference that Keshe Foundation is presenting. You're looking in the Far East to set up a structure. We have achieved our goal of negotiation with the government in Persian Gulf. So you will see very soon a structure set up as a manufacturing in the Persian Gulf. And this direct communication with the governments has given us a lot of opportunities, the new system, plus these conferences. These conferences, we prepare the nations for the next one. And while we are in, we go back. We were in Brazil 3 weeks ago for the conference. And when we arrived, and as I explained to you, we were asked to extend our stay, which we knew when we arrived it's going to be extended, and we were allowed to stay with the BRICS groups, and our talks and negotiation BRICS groups was very fruitful. And we see the next step, we came back to Brazil on a, what we call solidifying and building up the connections to confirm. And then you will see the results of it very, very soon. We are dealing with governments. Keshe Foundation dealing in what we call individual basis, but your work has been completed and is still completing, is developing. But with what you've done in these countries has given us the opportunity to negotiate with the governments. And one of the first things we do, we put everything on the table in respect to the Belgian situation, that they have to make a decision. And it's very, very positive, they understand. And the governments don't go to read, because the readers, they know how it was set up. As we call it, there's a colonization through technology. Before, they used to raid the countries and colonize it. Now they try to control technologies that they can control the others, and this has to an end, has come to an end. And the government had to start understanding how the game was played. And as I told you, we have a very strong support in our appeal in the European Court of Justice. And our appeal is directly to the government of Belgium, not the individuals. Because the structure of the government destroyed documents, the structure of the government in the judiciary has falsified documents. So somebody inside has to have such power. So who is the one who got the power? And the government has started seeing it. And don't forget, we have pictures with a king intimidating with a queen. We've published where the king and the queen sit down for an hour and a half and intimidate the scientists. Governments can understand because we have pictures taken by literally supporters of the Keshe Foundation in the cafe when the intimidation was taking place. We put the whole thing on the table, documents from the people who were present in the court and as affidavit. Our case in what do you call it, European Court of Justice, is solid. And we'll see a lot of changes. And the governments are taking position in that respect that they're ignoring all the things, but it showed the weaknesses in the structure of colonization by technology, by killing scientists. And so we are engaging governments, and the first thing we do, we put the facts. We've been committed, or a false, what do you call it, documentation is there. They can see it. Because very interesting is the same case number in the court in Belgium, first one says terrorist. And the only thing they've changed when the American refused to accept me as a terrorist, they said it's a scientist. They've used the same court case number and they changed it to fraud. This is the amazing thing what the stupid Belgians have done. They should have made a new case as, what do you call it, as a fraud or whatever. They've used the same case number and they've changed the terrorist summons into fraud. And this has alerted Americans very much in what, how is done. And you will see it. They played with everything. And these documents are submitted to European Court of Justice. And it's amazing. They tried to drag it maybe for 2 or 3 years. But the longer they drag it, the more gives us a chance for other nations to see into the operation of the collective between the Belgians and the Americans, how they have killed many scientists using Canada as a point of arrest. It'll be very interesting how it merging, and then you will understand the daughter of Howe is another victim in the same process.
There's a lot going on in Canada right now regarding that issue, and we're having discussions about how to interact with China specifically in that regard right now.
Well, yes, because what that is why the King of Belgium has made the recent trip to Canada. They're looking for sanctuary. They're looking for a place to abdicate, and because they did all the crimes between them and Canada and the United States, the Belgian monarchy is looking for a sanctuary in Canada. And if you look at the report, he was there very recently, out of nowhere. Because the hope. Pardon?
There's talk of other people of the monarchy wanting to settle in Canada as well recently. Yeah,
we could. It's a final application. Yeah,
influx of refugees from England. Royalty.
Yeah, but you got to understand
all over the world. This is a big issue. You're gonna have to deal with royalty refugees. They're gonna need their own refuge because the people may not be happy with where they happen to end up, and totally with.
Yeah, but you got to understand, Canada has been collaborating in a lot of assassination and arrest and stealing technology from scientists in collaboration with Belgium and United States.
Yes, absolutely.
Now, they think if they go to Canada, they have a sanctuary, they will give it. But the next step in European Court of Justice, once we go through it, we have enough evidence for 7 other scientists who've been murdered through the same process. And that was directly taking the kingdom into the Human Court of Justice in Den Haag. And it's no government. It's there's enough evidence of the direct connection. They're trying to preempt what might happen to them beforehand. As one of the Keshe Foundation knowledge says, no Belgian monarch came to Canada for 38 years. And it's a bit dodgy why you make a trip suddenly so fast. It's not just the monarchy, there are other, what do you call it, presidents who are in the same position. You got to understand, when I was kept 11 days in Canada in the airport and was threatened to be killed by the Canadian, what do you call it, customs or the police, because the guy said, I get my instructions from Hillary Clinton. She's deciding your destiny, not us. And it was very interesting, because at that time when I was there was another conference of G something, and they were all there and they panicked that the Iranian nuclear physicist is there. And Hillary Clinton has a say. And we saw what happened to Hillary Clinton. Go and see she went to make peace for the same reason. She's in a bad state of mind and mental condition today. She's near vegetation, cabbage state, more or less, whatever they can push her to move and make. But these things have been bandits working together. Now, we'll see. It's good for humanity, we reach a point of justice. Arc is still open in Canada. And the point of is, how many other scientists have kept silence with the intimidation and arrest and stealing technology from? And this cannot be one of. We know of many. And is it worth traveling over the space of Canada? And that's why when I came to Mexico, I came through, I thought it was a safe transit through Canada. We don't do that anymore. We take direct flights into South America, different routes that we don't need to go through criminal states. And my advice is to everyone, avoid the airspace of Canada. That's what they do. I've been a victim. Huawei is another one. We think Canada is impartial, but Canada has become a point of stealing technologies and capturing scientists and developers. But it's part of the process of human race maturing.
Yes.
Any other question?
Dan had asked.
You're rubbing your hand. It sounds like you're cold.
No, I just relished your answer. I think I like that. So thank you. It is a little cold here, but it's not that really. Dan had asked, what will happen in April and what will come in 18 months? I think you already answered.
We are trying to negotiate with the Iranian government to show the space technology in Iran. 1st of April. The technology for it is available, and after January, now that I have finished with the medical side and is going in the hand of a very capable man in the foundation to see it through. We concentrate on the environment and the space technology which is worked on, and the rest to be. Our target is to show the what we call the enhancement unit simultaneously in four places around the world: Arizona, China, now Brazil, and Iraq. This is important for us, that the technology is shown simultaneously across this planet. At the same time, we go to the space technology with Iraq. As I said, it depends how we tune the system. Authenticating evidences, elevating the soul of the man, producing materials, or becoming a spaceship. Or the source of energy. This is a, as I said, is a universal system. It says on it, it's not the name, it's a functionality of it. In the universe, Earth rotates, creates energy, food, life, and everything else. And this is called a universal system. Now you understand more. In 18 months' time, I leave the Keshe Foundation as I am today, and I go back into research and choose a private life. In so many ways, Christ is the same in completing his vision. And we are not here to claim position and power, we are here to go elevate the soul of the man. I take direction towards the research and development, and like many of you, live the life of that and enjoy the presence of new life. And this is what is our plan, and this is pushed one way or another. By that time, the speed of development is so rapid that I think it's time to let the man to walk and see if he falls, to give you a hand. We have nourished enough to be able to stand up and push it and guide it to the, what do you call it, time. 21st of March 21 is my day to leave the foundation mark, but we'll see if we can achieve it. But in running it, but in the background, the research and living a life will be part of it. I want to nourish a new life, which I have been waiting for. And to me, it's a pleasure to be in that position. the structure of the Keshe Foundation is at this time to be solid. We saw the failures of it when I was in China, that, as I explained to Keshe Foundation manager, I was expecting that the Keshe Foundation people would pull everything together while I was trying to develop China and the rest. But it shows the weaknesses in the system. Now we structure it that lives as a unit, and many people take a position that control of it. I start traveling with Keshe Foundation management team in different organizations, part of it, that they start learning what I used to do. In Istanbul, meeting the world leaders, in Dubai, meeting the what we call the ruling families. I was accompanied by the members of the Keshe Foundation management team. The same in Brazil, all the meetings, management team said to be, they learn ways It's not me anymore. And they have to learn the ways that the young generation, that the next generation, and the experience of lifetime with governments, I can show them kind of for next few, what they call it, time, that they take charge, to get the confidence that they can sit with world leaders, they can sit, negotiate with what you call governors, that they can start governing to change the course of humanity. And they will learn. But this time is not when I'm stepping down, it'll be left for someone to take. I'll train the whole education foundation team on the top, that they teach the next generation. And it's interesting how only man is standing in front of the king or a crown prince or a minister of a cabinet of a country. And they see themselves that they are normal people and they want the betterment of their nation, and we are there to support it. And this is what the Keshe Foundation team on the top is going through with me at the moment. They're traveling within Brazil in all our negotiations. The head of the Keshe Foundation allies with me, Stanley. Adopted for what you call the communication, the whole structure that with me. And the Keshe Foundation Brazil team, they learned how to handle, how to be. And gradually this transformation will come in. And the same in Malta, we expect to bring the organization of the Keshe Foundation as a headquarters to Malta. So when we meet in Malta, the head of the Chinese Keshe Foundation will be with us. The head of the Keshe Foundation here will be with us. The structure manufacturing, the management team of the Keshe Foundation to decide collectively in the location and how we're going to take the next step. And this is part of the handing over. I have one wish in my life and I hope to be fulfilled in the time to come, and that's the time for me to step down. But still in the background to give to support and develop, and in a way to set the structure.
Thank you for clarifying that, Mr. Keshe. We had Jalal with his hand up here. I know we should let you go soon here because you've got other things to do. And we're going through the flu besides. So perhaps we should.
It's a strange. All the men in our team have got the flu, no women. The women escaped. We don't think that the delivery went to infect men. So all of us men, we suffer with this flu, the high fever and everything else.
So maybe we
the women are okay. We don't know why. Oh, it was given to us by a woman. I think it's anti-allergic. They know how to protect themselves.
Hi, Mr. Keshe. Good day.
Yes, sir. Good day, Jerry.
Mr. Keshe, I have two questions.
You always have two. And yeah, then when you finish 20... the first one, you say, this is my first question.
20 now.
Yeah.
Okay. And funny enough, my questions also regard Trinity. If I want to change the word plasma, for what I can change it? And second question is...
First question, let's answer the first question.
Okay.
You're asking the wrong person, or in a way the right person. We call it a GANS, because plasma has different understanding. And what we call it is a GANS. It's a nano state of gas of the fields. And with this gas technology is accepted world in a lot of dimensions. A lot of Keshe Foundation people who came from outside and they knew something about Ormus, they tried to say it's Ormus, and it's not, because we can clearly show it's a matter of state. But we see that's part of it. We've seen a clever trick recently by somebody in Brazil and other Brazilians trying to understand the process. They call it informed water, which you can never give information to water. So if you understand the work of the GANS, is not the informed, is a strength field balance energy. And what we use, we call it the gas water, which is actually the true what it is a gas in nano state, and we gather its energy through filtering it or by using it, converting it. So we use gas plasma technology, or we call it gas technology, which is accepted now by a lot of people because they understand it. Scientific world understand gas in nano state. So the one who are illiterate or people who just claim they understand something, they try to give it a different name that they can use it as they have become and the creator. We've seen that in Brazil, especially with Claudia. She uses this terminology to break up the foundation's men's way of mentality, and we asked her to stop using this. But in so many ways, gas is a gas. It's a gas in nano state. When you put a caustic, because of the high temperature, you past the point of melting in a rapid heat. So you evaporate it, becomes single atom, it's a vapor of it, becomes in the gas state. And then because of the immediate environmental coolness, it goes back, but it cannot take the molecular structure. It stays individually. And then in the next process, you spread the individually to singularity on its own, not being spaced with other elements or other, what do you call it, atoms. And so GANS is accepted technology. We don't call it a lot of people call it the plasma. We call it the plasma because plasma is the direction of the field. But the GANS is the source of the field. It's the sun. And it's understood by scientists very correctly, very rapidly.
Okay, Mr. Keshe. The second question. When is there any influence from the twin star of ours in us, in this creation?
Yes, continuous. And scientifically, a group of scientists led by a well-known scientist very recently, past decade or so, has shown that the cycle of what we see, meteorite showers that affects the condition of this planet and the whole of solar system, is when the twin star comes to close proximity and puts pressure on the plasma of this solar system and pushes materials towards the center. Yes, it does.
And well, that's why
research papers, you will find that.
And that's why we see, and that's why we see a lot of elevation in the human knowledge because of that?
No, this is Not really, because it's according to this research, which fits actually shows a cycle, how often the twin star comes close to us. It goes back to pointing out the position with the dinosaurs. It came through that cycle of closeness. It has a pattern. Every time they come close, we get a higher shower of meteorites crossing towards to go back to the center. It's just like a balloon, you pressurize it so everything moves to the center. The closeness, when they come very close, they get to this. But due to loss of a lot of their fields, both stars, into the galaxy, and due to pull of the galaxy, now this solar system and its twin are in the closer into the center wing of the Milky Way, we call it, they will be pushed and they merge. And that will create a position of what we call two stars hitting each other or becoming one. But that is in the future. But it's inevitable. They touch us, they affect us, and they wreck our environment. And as you've seen, a high level of meteorites moving towards because of the pressure on the boundary of the solar system has brought us a lot of what we call bones, we call them dinosaur bones, because that condition changed the position of the planet. And in so many ways, thanks to that meteorite, whatever condition created, allowed us, our ancestors as mammals, to come out of the holes and beginning of the end of the race, or whatever it's supposed to be, according to this, what they call some scientists. But in fact, if you understand it, and we go through the process of the human race and understanding of how the different races of man in different planets or a different part of this planet, it become very clear that you just needed to have one gene or one cell to be airborne and land on another condition of the same for another life in a different part of this planet to start. As we say, replication of life, once it's established, it's very easy to follow. And this is how we get fish into the, where there was no fish before. If you create the right condition, which was created number of times on this planet, and if you understand that we, many human beings in the process of burning and ashes become the gas cell of us, carries the DNA, and if it lands in the right place, if you can understand the totality of it, it becomes the creator of another life. And then there is a further point that if human life has managed to exist here and is developed to the position it is now, and there is a parallel environmental condition anywhere in this universe, can it be transferred across through the natural process of the energy transfer? And then the question comes, is the life of the man originated on this planet? If we can transmute to another, to understand about the fields of the plasma, was our planet a condition that it could be transmuted to? These will be answered by the Universal Community as the archives of the universe will be opened.
You already answered it in your teaching.
As part of it, man has gradually to understand he's not the center of the universe. And the knowledge is there, is being open to understand, not open to accept. If you understand it, you already accept it.
Thank you, Mr. Keshe.
Thank you indeed. Those of our Brazilian knowledge seekers who will attend the what we call the small conference we organized in Brasilia today, this afternoon. I hope we'll have the pleasure to meet you all. And amongst us, we'll try to share knowledge and how we can bring the technology in a faster way into Brazilian dimensions for the nation. And I know many of you have been trying to get tickets to be here, and some of you could not get because of such short notice. You're still with us, with your soul, and hopefully as we come back, as we've been invited to be here for an international conference very soon with other world leaders to Keshe Foundation to be part of in that conference. We'll be back in Brazil in the next few weeks. And as we present the technology, hopefully in different dimensions around the world, Brazilians will be part of the structure of the spreading the knowledge in the South America country. Any other question, or shall we call it a day?
There's always more questions, Mr. Keshe, even though sometimes we have lulls. I think that we should let you go, though, and I can suggest a couple of questions in the YouTube that we can carry them on till next week, perhaps.
What are they?
Okay, want to know. Philip asked.
You know, a lot of people complain. There's a lot of people complain, especially we had a conference in Iran, and our moderator was trying to get as many questions. They complain, she's controlling everything. We cannot answer questions. I don't want you to be accused of that. He only reads what he likes.
Well, we try to get
carry on.
Pretty much all the questions in here. Philip asks a question about Tesla erected his towers on the same earth lines as the Giza pyramids. Is this like the halo around the head where the universal fields enter the planet?
What?
Yeah, I kind of went what too, but I'll try to ask it again. Tesla erected his towers on the same earth lines as the Giza pyramids. Is this like a halo around the head when the universal fields enter the planet, or where the universal fields enter the planet, Brandon?
Not really. Russian decided where his post going to be when they voted off him.
Okay, we'll take the second question from Philip, which is, says, seven sages in the ancient Sumerian texts are holding a bag and a crystal pine cone. Is this the stronger giving to the weaker, projecting the universal fields to elevate the soul, like the KFSSI enhancer?
I don't know. Depends how you want to interpret these things. And we can't interpret everything just to be the benefit of the Keshe Foundation is this and that.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, there's a lot of things in that one statement that could be taken many ways.
A lot of scientists have done the work according to their understanding. And a lot of people, as scientists, develop things they never understood. But if they could share it, it would change a lot of things for a lot of us.
Mr. Keshe, we have someone named Arthur, who I don't know if they've been here before, who had their hand up for a while. And we can take a roll of the dice here and allow them to speak, if that's okay.
Okay, keep your finger on the button.
Okay, well,
carry on. Let's see what we have.
Okay, Arthur, could you unmute your mic and go ahead, please?
Hi, my name is Arthur, and I'm from Scotland. Thank you very much.
Where?
Well, just about near Edinburgh.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. Well, I'm born in Latvia, but I moved to Scotland 10 years ago. So, staying here just now. Thank you very much for your teaching today. And I just wanted to ask you about the blue light spaceship you saw at the Brazil, and I wanted to ask you, was it a field spaceship? Like, was it made through the soul? Does the universal community made it through the soul, or is it a reactor like a type of spaceship?
Oh, we had it last night.
You had it last night?
Again.
Really?
I had it last night. Yes, I videoed it, and our head of Keshe Foundation in Brazil, we are all in the same place. He did the same. Let me just see if I can send it. That's his recording. I try to forward it to where are you, Rick? Where can I find you, Rick?
With all the rings?
See it.
And is it still was the rings?
It's exactly the same as before.
Did you give it a name?
It was on. He took one at 23:10, and he took one at 32 minutes past 12. Let me see how I can get it. More, what does more say? No. I have to do it a different way. It is Just let me see. Copy the link if I do it.
Brazil, I think Brazil got many activities, yeah, like in the region.
I don't know.
Oh, I think they do. I think Brazil and Mexico, they have a lot of them, I think.
How come, Rick, I can't find you here? Oh, let me see. Maybe it's like Rick. Okay, gotcha. Can you open what I sent you on a private chat, Rick?
No, it says I'm not a member of that chat where it was posted.
Yeah, not. Okay. Let me see how I can do it. Oops, I found it. Oh, you see, I don't have much knowledge of these things, but I gotta find it, okay. You will see it. This is taken by the knowledge seekers. So let me see how I'm gonna do it. It should be with you on your chat, Rick. Let me know once you get it. It's downloading. What happened? We saw it last night. It's the second time we sit in what do you call Brazil. And I was there for about 2-3 hours. But this will become a norm. And you will see if you can see the it's very hard to see it or record it on the camera. I think that's on the 10 second, you will see it back up. But these are what we call field center systems. Have you received it, Dick?
Yes, I'm just getting it now.
These are this will carry on with us in every nation we'll visit as part of the our international conferences.
Okay, I'll share that now.
You see the edge of the light. It's very faint because we cannot, you see the circle. We don't have, you see the shape.
What's that
object.
Like? Yeah, is that the ring? Yeah, the I see the ring. That's a fade ring. Yeah, around it.
Yeah. Yeah, it's the same as Stammer? What we showed before.
Stammer?
The more bright light is the moon, yes.
Oh, okay, yeah. Mm-hmm. I've seen it before in Scotland as well. Yes. I couldn't understand. But I've seen the fade
the
ring.
The one you see, the daylight. No, this is not a fade ring. This is a full spaceship, you see it. When we were in Sanya, for the night when the Universal Council charter was getting written, around about, I think, 1 or 2 o'clock in the morning, we saw a full display. And there was... we were with 2 families of what they call Keshe Foundation in different near proximity to each other, and we could both see it. And it was a beautiful display. And that display will be shown very soon in another location. I know where and when it'll happen, but then we can record it. You will see a full what we call a spaceship with satellite spaceships with a full operation.
So they made the spaceship through their soul? I mean, that's a group effort. Like many souls, you can't
explain. I explained this type of spaceship how it's made. When we saw it in Italy, the Italian Air Force with high altitude helicopters and planes were trying to look down what's in it. Actually, the Italian noise of high altitude helicopter brought our attention to see it. And they literally jam what you call electromagnetic fields communication, but they have a zone, preference. And you have to fly. The aircraft lose all directions. And the structure of communication with the universal community is that does not create harm to no one. And all these things before every interaction is well thought out. You will understand in the future, or mankind will understand in the future. Everything not to create any harm for any interface and interaction is calculated, is considered. You got to understand when you work on the HS of peace, you look at things totally in a different way, and you look for the safety of the others and correct conduct first. And this is part of the ethos of the universal community. And because the knowledge is so advanced, man's knowledge, all your communication, everything is so primitive that, we can just bypass it and allow it to happen. But the space technology developments, all these become into consideration. Mm-hmm. Thank you very much. I think we've spoken with you before with your accent.
Yeah, you did. Yeah, and I've forgot to ask you. Well, we didn't have the time. We never had a really enough time. I just really want to real quick want to ask you. See the research and development, and we're gonna gather our groups, and maybe we'll try to just to try new things. Should we gather the group for the field spaceship? For example, should we come together and start maybe trying to understand?
That's your decision. We pass the responsibility to the knowledge seekers to decide what they want. Mm-hmm. So if you're a knowledge seeker, you registered and you're there, and you say, I want to test this, and the other people would like to collaborate with you, or you start it up and the other people will join and you put it back on the table. That's the decision. The decision of the research comes from your side, the knowledge seekers. We provide the facility, the platform, and the materials.
Mm-hmm. A platform and materials.
Yes, if it is something sensible, we can afford it. If you want to make a half a battleship, we don't have the money for it. We never get involved in it. But something sensible, we always look.
Mm-hmm. It has to be an effort of many sources. Probably one person can do a field spaceship. Is that correct? It's probably many people together.
Have you understood the strength of your soul yet?
Partially.
You did mention one time, Mr. Keshe, that it's often in the configuration of four that beings in the universe travel together. Is that still?
It can do it in different ways. Depends on the strength of the mind. The original, what I call not original, the primitive first flight system any race makes is a copy of the Earth. Mm-hmm. But if you notice, we already done that with the Iranian space program.
Mm-hmm. Reactor.
Because the Iranian reactor is our phase. We try to pass as fast as possible. Some cultures, hundreds of years, relied on one single reactor. It's very effective, actually. It works very. It works very nice, but controlling it is a bit dodgy sometimes. But the star formation is a more solid way to do it. It has more control characteristics, but at the same time, the star formation has got its own pitfalls in many, many aspects, but it has a lot of advantages. So if you understand that, you can create a spaceship with muscle. But as you cannot steal, you have to see who would like to join you as a soul to be a passenger with you. So you better have good lovers,
mm-hmm.
true lovers, be it the wife, be it the children, that they take that step of journey with you.
Yeah.
Enjoy Edinburgh. I hope you're not snowed in.
No. There was a festival weekend in August. I enjoyed the August. August was really nice. But it's the winter time now, and it's just not easy time now.
I know.
It's actually the roots of my family in Edinburgh.
Oh my God, don't go there. A beautiful city.
Unfortunately, haven't met any too many knowledge seekers here in Scotland. I've heard about.
I think they are too busy drinking, huh?
Maybe. Well, it's just, yeah, well, I'm in a golden age of Gans group as well, you know, been contacting people there and as well as anybody wants to develop. And but that's one of the problems. You can't share the knowledge when you want it and how you want it, you know, you want more people to
I think that position will change in the coming months.
And we will find
maybe it. Even sooner.
If you build a
you see, it's
people will show. There's this saying, if you build it, they will come. You know, if you build a center, if you even just want to have a workshop or some sort of information gathering, start talking to friends, even there's a lot of avenues that way to just open up the local areas so that people start to become more accepting. That's a big step. Ask Alex. Alex. Skorik, who's been, trying to do that in his area. It's a difficult job, but yet he now has on his wall, I think it's like 330 people in the local area that have signed the peace treaty and have, you know, at least agreed out of the 9,000 in his local area, I think it was. So that just shows it can be done over with persistence and creating your own world within your world.
Yeah, but you have to understand that Scotland is slightly different, like everybody else, everywhere else. The Scottish, like the Scotch and other parts more than anything else. When you can make a Gans of a Scotch that they can get drunk faster, everybody becomes knowledge seeker.
Am I correct? Maybe that's the secret.
My son lives in Edinburgh and I know the mentality.
Yeah, hopefully something will happen in Scotland. They're not bad people. They're really nice people.
Nobody is bad. Just find out how you can make Gans of a Scotch.
Scotch.
Have more, and they don't have to pay for it and they can get drunk easy. So you'll find out everybody wants to know about the knowledge.
Yeah, I just wish there would be more knowledge seekers.
Yeah, but the secret is finding how to make Gans of whiskey, huh? And then you give a water to them and they get drunk and that's it. Everybody will know about the knowledge seekers.
They find this want to know.
Yeah, the Scotch seekers they become.
Especially anyway. If it's cheaper.
It is cheaper. It's the water which makes you drunk. What do you want?
That's what I'm saying. If they can get drunk on water, they'll be sold on that.
On what? He said, I'll make your wine out of water. Now I make your Scotch out of water.
Good one.
Okay, so we
have
any other things.
Theodore is the only one who's left with his hand up here, but I know
what does he want?
Let's have that as the last question. We'll have to make it quick, probably. Theodore, would you like to go ahead?
Hello, Mr. Keshe. Can you hear me?
Hello, yes. Hello. Yes.
This is Ted in West Virginia. And I was thinking about what you were saying about turning the light on within ourselves and the visible light. And then when the gentleman was speaking about the twin star coming around again, I was wondering if we were to start emitting the light, learning how to emit it ourselves, and becoming part of that understanding, would it like keep things stabilized during the time when the other planet or the other star comes around? Is that like partially a purpose of getting to that level to like stabilize the Earth or to create like a larger Magrav field around the Earth during times that other things come around like that?
I hope your great, 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 as many as you can put on it, grandchildren are there at that time.
Okay, I understand.
They still remember the knowledge.
Well, there's something about what Arthur was saying too about when people come together, and if we come together with a purpose, like if we emit the light and join with the starships above the Earth, like what is the ultimate purpose there? Is everybody find like a common focus to be intent on, or is it more of like still trying to find individuality within that?
There is another way to look at it. What do you do when you go on a trip sightseeing? Do you do it for yourself, or do you do it to take a selfie to send to someone that I'm there? You understand? It's for the state of the man's soul to understand what do you expect and what you want. You got to understand the next step beyond the present understanding is that when you manage to enter to that level of the elevation of the soul to be able to be part of these structures, then you find out these structures are connected across universe. Then you can travel different positions through understanding this. So if you manage to get to that level of the soul, and then you find out it's not just the spaceship that you enter. You enter into web network of seeing the universe. The man will understand that as well in the coming time. These spaceships are in touch with each other, communicate and travel. So man will become instantaneously man of universe. If I tell you what will be achieved, if man can reach that point, many of you will queue up to give your life, to be part. It's not just joining a spaceship, it's understanding beyond what is open to soul of the man in the dimension of the universal community. And at the same time, if you can understand that elevation to the next level, you can travel across universes.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Thank you very much.
We call it the day. Thank you very much. We call it the day.
Can I have a request from Azar? Mr. Keshe?
Why, as I cannot speak?
No, because of the time. Azar, please, are you there?
Yes, I'm here. Can you hear me?
Yes, Azar, please, if you do that Shabzi, huh?
Uh-huh.
Can you remember my name, please?
Yes, I send it to you, no problem.
Okay, thank you.
You can smell it. No problem. Thank you very much indeed.
Thank you indeed.
Let's see where we achieve what we achieve, and hopefully next. next week it will be what do you call it? One of the last two meetings before end of this year of the Christian calendar, and we'll meet some of the knowledge seekers in Brasilia tonight and or this afternoon in the conference, and let's see what we can achieve.
And the question is, the meeting private in that Dan asked in the Q&A here?
It is for those who registered. Oh, I think around about 100 people have registered to be present. And the auditorium is for about 100 people. We are not broadcasting it. It's just for people who are attending.
Okay, thanks for being
We do not broadcast any of the conferences. Don't forget, we had the Italian woman who was very angry with the letter to show her magic. She wrote a lot of rubbish and whatever about Austria. So we're going to get some of these people who can't get the talk, and then they have to show they exist. Very interesting. I explained before. These people come to the foundation to confirm they exist, but they use the foundation to confirm their existence. When they don't get the opportunity to abuse it, then there is something wrong with us. And we've seen that. So we ask people not to take photographs or whatever. And this lady was so adamant, I want to show my game. And then we couldn't do it because it's the Keshe Foundation, what do you call it, knowledge seekers. We are not a game, playing game platform. She's got very upset. You don't let me show my game, I'm going to do this and that. So it's good. In a way, it tests failure for their souls. But collectively, we do not like, we take pictures for archives by the Keshe Foundation team of these conferences, but we don't publish it. Maybe in the future, it'll be published by the, what we call, in the archives of the foundation.
Hello, Mr. Keshe.
Oh, we got somebody very strange. Would you like to say who you are? I know who you are.
I'm Ling. I just get a question.
From China.
Yeah, so I hope.
Lynn, let me explain. Wang Lin is the head of the Keshe Foundation of China. All the beautiful things you see and developments in China is through her work and hard work. She works
24/7.
As you can hear, she's translating while I'm speaking to. Okay, carry on, please.
Sorry, I forgot to switch off my microphone. Just one knowledge seeker, he's asking how the hot plasma interact with the cold plasma. I think maybe he has a wrong understanding. Maybe can you explain how plasma interact to create hot or cold, and that could be more easier to understand.
The heat is the state of matter of the plasma. Plasma has no temperature. When you call it hot and cold, when you have a heat, what we call created out of what we understand, high temperature, that's a matter of state plasma. It's nothing to do with the plasma which we use in space plasma technology. When it becomes crowded plasma in interaction with each other, they release fields which in turn, we see it as a heat under the hot plasma. Cold plasma is what we call as a room temperature plasma. Or if we define the plasma the way we do, magnetic field in motion. If you have a crowded plasmas, it's a fields interacting with each other, like the Earth and the Sun's fields, we create the heat of the Sun. But if you notice the heat of the Sun only is within the parameters of the inertial effect of the plasma of the Earth, not the magnetic gravitational field of the Earth. So it's primarily the matter state field, the strength of the magnetic fields. We call heat, hot plasma, create the different higher level in respect to its environment.
Oh, thank you so much. I think that's very clearly clarified. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Any other questions?
Okay. No, we need to let you go, Mr. Cash.
Let you go, yeah. We'll see what happens. We'll see you next week, hopefully. We will be another point on this planet. And then after that, another point on this planet. And for next months, as head of the Keshe Foundation said, we'll be living out of suitcase. But it's worth it that the family of the Keshe Foundation is more or less getting a chance to expand and clarify a lot of things for themselves. Thank you very much for today. And hopefully we come together again next week, the same time. But not what it says, the same place at the same time.
Maybe we need to pack spacesuits in our suitcase instead.
Oh, we don't need to have a gravity. A spacesuit belongs to NASA, huh? We've gone a little bit further than that.
Very good. Thank you very much. Thank you.
See you
Thank you very
week.
Much.
Thank you. Bye-bye. Bye-bye.
All right. Thank you, everyone.
Mamy koniec tłumaczenia na dzisiaj, tak więc jak ktoś chce zabrać głos, to zapraszam serdecznie.
No, dzięki Jarku. Witam wszystkich. To może tradycyjnie postaram się tu dość szybko skrócić parę tematów, które było poruszane. Jeśli chodzi o te wątki geopolityczne, to tu mieliśmy kolejną dawkę informacji na temat tej jednostki uniwersalnej, wytłumaczenia, do czego ona może służyć w zasadzie zastosowanie w każdym kierunku też. Rozwój badań, który będzie się odbywał, który cały czas się odbywa, ale też zachętani są prywatni studenci, żeby właśnie od nowego semestru, od stycznia będą się oni organizowali w grupy pracujące nad różnymi projektami, więc nawet poszukiwacze wiedzy słuchający, uczestniczący w wykładach prywatnych i publicznych będą mogli swoją cegiełkę dołożyć do tej wiedzy. Prezentacja tych systemów, doktor też mówił, że chciałby, żeby odbyła się w tym samym czasie w czterech miejscach na świecie, między innymi w Iranie, w Arizonie. Był też ten temat pokoju przywódców. Oczywiście o tym, co się działo też w Kanadzie, po raz kolejny zostało to przytoczone. Mieliśmy pytanie później odnośnie, można powiedzieć, synonimu plazmy, no jak jeszcze można nazwać plazmę, i doktor Kesze tłumaczył, że plazma to jest słowo też, które jest używane w innych dziedzinach fizyki, więc coraz szerzej jest ta technologia rozumiana właśnie pod hasłem technologia Gansu, plazmy, czy plazmy Gansu, czy coś w tym kierunku. Było też pytanie, co będzie doktor Kesze robił za 18 miesięcy. To była informacja o tym, że chce odejść na emeryturę, zająć się badaniami i w ten sposób cieszyć się tutaj swoim życiem na ziemi. Także wszystkie te struktury, które są ustawiane, są po to, żeby fundacja mogła funkcjonować sama niezależnie, nie tylko poprzez kopiowanie tego, co pierwszy pokazuje, ale poprzez własne dążenie do własnych wywodów, rozszerzanie tej technologii i zrozumienia przede wszystkim tej technologii coraz bardziej. Była też tematyka bliźniaczych gwiazd, no, który pierwszy tłumaczył deszcz meteorytów, w jaki sposób, dlaczego, co jest powodem występowania tych zjawisk, tutaj wskazywał między innymi na ciśnienie wywołane na zewnętrznych warstwach galaktyki, zresztą interakcje dwóch bliźniaczych gwiazd i to wszystko w pewien sposób zagęszczające, coś co zagęszcza, powoduje częstsze występowanie właśnie tego typu rzeczy jak meteoryty. Był też temat dinozaurów, o tym jak to życie na Ziemi było, replikuje się właśnie pod wpływem tych warunków, które istnieją, to życie wygląda inaczej. Dinozaury, wiemy, to ciśnienie było mniejsze między plazmą Ziemi a Słońca i właśnie to spowodowało, że one miały troszkę inne wymiary, rozmiary swojej fizyczności niż ma to miejsce na przykład teraz. Zresztą doktor Pierwszy tutaj mówi, że ta replikacja życia tutaj na Ziemi w wodzie zwłaszcza jest dość łatwa, jeśli spojrzymy właśnie na ryby. Zresztą naukowcy też, to było odwołanie do tego, że naukowcy też mówią, że życie wypełzało na ląd tutaj na Ziemi, że właśnie to w wodzie zaczęło się to życie. Ten wspólny mianownik myślenia, można powiedzieć, jest tutaj obecny i co do tego wszyscy są zgodni, że to właśnie woda była źródłem, z którego, można powiedzieć, to życie powstało i z którego wypełzło dalej, ewoluowało na różne inne, można powiedzieć, kształty tej fizyczności. Był też ciekawy wątek palenia ciał, czyli takiego obrządku, można, wiadomo, tradycyjnie gdzieś w naszej kulturze czy w naszej religii mówimy o ogrzewaniu ciała, ale także możliwe jest ich palenie. Tutaj doktor Pierwszy mówił o tym, gdzie ciało przychodzi właśnie z Tangansu. Jeśli dobrze wyląduje, to tworzy ta informacja, to DNA tworzy kolejne życie i od razu tutaj przeszedł do, porównał to w tej dualności naszej egzystencji do tego, co dzieje się też na poziomie naszej duszy, że nasza dusza w kosmosie też tylko tutaj poprzez transfer energii zmienia swoją pozycję, jest w stanie podróżować. Zresztą o spaceshipie też tutaj mieliśmy później powiedziane, jest w stanie podróżować przez te przestworza wszechświata po to, żeby zajmować się coraz to inne pozycje dla manifestacji swojej fizyczności. I tutaj parę filozoficznych pytań, można powiedzieć, czy nasze życie pochodzi z tej planety, czy być może ten galaktyczny wiatr, ten transfer energii przywiał w cudzysłowie to życie tutaj na tą Ziemię, nasze dusze i kreację później fizyczności w tym środowisku. Było pytanie od Artura ze Szkocji o statek w Brazylii. Doktor Pierwszy, pytanie odnosiło się do tego, czy ten statek był właśnie z duszy, czy z reaktorów, jaki to był rodzaj statku, żeby doktor Pierwszy go jakoś się określił, sklasyfikował, na co on powiedział, że zeszłej nocy w Brazylii też widzieli taki statek i od razu tutaj wiązała się rozmowa na temat charakterystyki tego statku. Doktor Pierwszy mówił, że był jednorodzeniowy w pewien sposób, system jednego pola, jak to nazwał, prymitywny, początkowy taki system, który jest dość efektywny, ale trudny w sterowaniu. Tutaj też było nawiązanie do tego irańskiego reaktora, który parę razy widzieliśmy na wykładach z taką kopułą, z okienkami, gdzie można było widzieć, co się tam dzieje w środku. Myślę, że każdy gdzieś z tyłu głowy widzi obrazek takiego reaktora i to właśnie był tego rodzaju system. Doktor Pierwszy mówił tutaj też o tym, że możemy zrobić taki statek, taki spaceship z jednej duszy, ale ciekawie to określił, myślę, że warto to sobie gdzieś po raz kolejny przesłuchać, ale wydaje mi się, że powiedział, że żeby nie kraść, potrzebujesz więcej pasażerów niż tylko statek z jednej duszy. Tu myślę, można się odnieść do tego, że jeden element zawsze potrzebuje czegoś, czym mógłby reagować, więc być może ten aspekt kradnięcia jest właśnie tym byciem, może jak jakaś przystawka, pijawka, coś na zasadzie to, co potrzebuje punktu referencji, punktu odniesienia, czyli w jakiś sposób, można powiedzieć, pożytuje na energii na tego punktu referencji, tego, z czym wchodzi w interakcję, gdzie w większej ilości, zresztą kiedyś też dr Keshe mówił w stosunku do tego stanu, który nazywamy schizofrenią, że to jest, że takiej osoby nie bałby się, przez chwilę by się nie wahał, żeby wsadzić do spiesznika i zabrać ze sobą, że to jest gwarancja replikacji życia też. Więc ta wieloduszowość, można powiedzieć, w przypadku tutaj została podkreślona. Rick też nawiązywał do tego, że kiedyś dr Keshe mówił, że potrzeba czterech dusz, żeby właśnie taką formację gęby stworzyć. Także widzimy, że tutaj opcji jest wiele, ale różnią się, można powiedzieć, efektywnością i łatwością sterowania tego, co jest konstruowane. Ciepła, zimna plazma. Mieliśmy pytanie od Wang Lin z Chin, szefowej fundacji właśnie w Chinach, na co dr Keshe wyjaśnił, że ciepło jest stanem materii, że kiedy ktoś się pyta ciepłą, zimną plazmę, to jest mowa o plazmie stanu materii. Dla porównania, żeby przybliżyć, co to jest ta plazma, o której mówimy w technologii Gansu, to podał przykład tego, że mamy Ziemię i Słońce, te dwie plazmy. Można powiedzieć, ich dusze same w sobie nie mają jakiejś temperatury, nie określa się ich stanu w taki sposób, tylko dopiero interakcja jednej plazmy z drugą, dotarcie się jednego pola z drugim powoduje właśnie wydzielanie się ciepła, czyli to, co obserwujemy, czy na powierzchni Słońca, czy na powierzchni Ziemi, tego stanu, gdzie obserwujemy stan materii, właśnie to, co jest atrybutem stanu materii, czyli ciepło. I w zasadzie tutaj to wszystko, jeśli chodzi o krótkie gdzieś tam streszczenie tych wątków, które były poruszane. Myślę, że dla wielu z nas nadchodzi czas odpoczynku, naładowania baterii i też posilenia nie tylko swojej fizyczności, ale też duszy w tym czasie, który w religii chrześcijańskiej czy katolickiej jest celebrowany, więc ze swojej strony i ze strony całego zespołu Fundacji Keshe w Polsce chciałem życzyć każdemu spokojnych, wesołych świąt, a my oczywiście spotkamy się w czwartek na kolejną dawkę wiedzy doktora Keshe z kolejnego warsztatu 307, który był w tym tygodniu, w zeszły czwartek. Także to wszystko z mojej strony. Dzięki.
Dziękuję bardzo, Przemku, za skrót i dodanie od siebie. Tak więc ja też się przyłączam i dziękuję za dzisiejsze spotkanie i życzę dobrej nocy. Tak więc do usłyszenia. Nadszedł czas zmiany, przejścia do prawdziwego działania wszechświata. I nadszedł czas, aby zrozumieć, że używamy stanu materii, by osiągnąć poziom zrozumienia duszy człowieka. Teraz rozumiesz, być może, dlaczego Kreator wysłał swoich posłańców w imię tego, co miałeś. To oni przynoszą uszy, aby można było ich użyć, gdy nadejdzie czas Mesjasza. Mogę nauczyć duszę i przesłanie. Nie by się przeciwstawiać, ale poprzez ich zrozumienie, przez tych, którzy stali się Mesjaszami, aby dawać ze swoich dusz, aby ich elewować. Zadanie stało się łatwe.
The school is there.
Szkoła jest tutaj i uczniowie są tutaj w oddaniu. Wtedy nie będzie żadnej walki między tym, co nazywają muzułmanami, a chrześcijanami. Baranek i lew będą jeść i spać w tym samym gnieździe. Chrześcijanie i muzułmanie będą spać i modlić się w meczecie, w tym samym kościele, w imię ich dusz, nie w imię religii, które są używane do tworzenia tak wielu konfliktów. Dla korzyści tych, którzy byli hiperaktywnymi dziećmi. Nadszedł czas, czas zmian jest tutaj. I jak powiedziałem, moje życzenie jest moim rozkazem. Jeśli pragniesz ujrzeć pokój, droga pokoju jest wyłożona bardzo wyraźnie. To dusza świadomości zbiorowej. Poprzez dawanie stworzy tą pozycję zmiany. Nic innego. W duszy człowieka nie ma długopisu. Jestem pewien, że po wejściu do społeczności uniwersalnej nigdy nie zobaczysz niczego zapisanego, ale równowagę pól duszy egzystencji. Staraj się być na tyle pokornym, aby nie stać się aroganckim w mocy, którą zrozumiałeś i posiadłeś. Inaczej wpadniesz w tą samą ścieżkę kościoła i meczetu. To jest to, co obiecaliśmy i to właśnie dostarczyliśmy. Musimy zrozumieć działanie duszy i musimy zrozumieć, że dusza człowieka jest gwiazdą w kosmosie Wszechświata. Jeśli porównamy duszę człowieka i tak wielu nas, 7 miliardów w jednym zbiorze, Ziemia jest jak galaktyka z tak wieloma gwiazdami. Kiedy patrzymy w głąb Wszechświata, widzimy galaktyki z setkami milionów gwiazd. Podobnie jest z planetą Ziemią. Niesie 7 miliardów pięknych gwiazd, które są duszą człowieka. Niesie z sobą duszę tak wielu trylionów zwierząt, roślin i wszystkiego innego. Jeśli więc patrzą ci, którzy nie widzą fizyczności Ziemi, i jej zawartości, co widzą? Widzą galaktykę z wielką ilością pięknych, świecących świateł. Każda według swojej siły. Każda zgodnie ze swoją pozycją. Niemowlę ma piękną duszę, podobnie jak staruszek. Dla tych niefizycznych, którzy nie widzą fizycznego wymiaru tej planety, ale widzą siłę pola, jesteśmy gromadami gwiazd. Ludzka rasa, każda pojedyncza dusza, nikt z daleka nie widzi. To jest dusza rybaka, to jest dusza kosmologa, to jest dusza prezydenta. Wszystkie świecą bez względu na fizyczność. To jest magia. Oto co nowa nauka musi przynieść człowiekowi. Kiedy patrzymy przez naszą duszę, widzimy tylko gwiazdy w innych duszach. I to jest przełom, to jest zrozumienie. Na tym właśnie polegają te wszystkie nauki. Dojście do dojrzałości następnego poziomu, aby zrozumieć daleki kosmos. Wszechświat jest ostrygą dla tych dusz, które służą. Wtedy człowiek jest gotowy do wejścia w kosmos. Wtedy człowiek jest gotowy, aby stać się częścią uniwersalnej społeczności, która została obiecana. Nigdy nie obiecywałem wam nieba. Zawsze obiecywałem wam elewację człowieka, aby przyłączył się do rodziny. A teraz macie klucz. To wy musicie otworzyć drzwi, aby zrozumieć, że mogę elewować duszę tych ludzi lub milionów innych dusz, że fizyczne życie na tej planecie zmieni się. Wtedy jestem godny bycia częścią społeczności uniwersalnej, by być, aby służyć, aby się rozwijać, by być tam, aby być częścią, że w cyklu życia Wszechświata staje się w byciu częścią, staje się częścią totalności. Kiedy człowiek osiągnie ten punkt, pojawi się nowy wymiar w sile duszy człowieka, który jest poza wyobrażeniem zrozumienia życia fizycznego. To jest brama do otwarcia nowego życia w nowym wymiarze, co jest poza wyobrażeniem tego, co mogliście nazwać nowym początkiem, nowym cyklem, gdzie ten cykl niesie ze sobą źródło stworzenia życia we Wszechświecie i Unikosie. To jest elewacja duszy, aby służyć. Stała się kluczem. Nie tron życia fizycznego. Czas jest odpowiedni, nadszedł czas, aby człowiek przeszedł przez ten proces.